Assalamualaikum and a good day. Today, we're going to be drawing a simple diagram of the typical intercostal space seen from the side view. Okay, we're going to be drawing it from this part, the superficial part, until this part, the deep part. We'll start the drawing by making two vertical lines representing the skin. And then, deeper to it, we have the superficial fascia. And to differentiate, since it has adipose tissue, we'll do it like this. Deeper to it, we have one muscle, the serratus anterior muscle. Okay, this is where it gets tricky. We're gonna draw the ribs along with the typical intercostal space. The ribs, well, we're gonna be drawing two of it by making two backward commas, where one at the top, one at the bottom. Extend this one a bit. The marrows. Okay. In this part here, we're going to be having three important muscles, which is, okay, first one, the external intercostal muscle. Deeper to it, we have the internal intercostal muscle. And then separated, we have the innermost intercostal muscle. Okay. To differentiate these three muscles, we're going to be drawing how the muscle fiber actually runs. The external intercostal muscle, we'll draw it like this. The internal intercostal muscle, we'll draw it like this. And then since the innermost intercostal muscle follows how the internal intercostal muscle runs, we'll just follow the same pattern. Like this. Okay, this empty part here, this one is called the neurovascular plane, in which it represents where the most of the vessels actually lie. Okay, first one, the most important part is this part here. This two part is called the costal groove of the rib. At this part here, we have three important vessels, which is from top to bottom, we have the intercostal vein, followed by the intercostal artery, and last one, the intercostal nerve. Same thing for the bottom rib. Vein, artery, and nerve. In this part here, we also have not so important branch, but we'll still add it for completeness. At the top part of the rib, we have the collateral branches. But instead of having the order of VAN, like this part here, the order is actually reverse, which is N, A, V. Notice how I draw these three branches are actually smaller than the intercostal branches, because this is actually a smaller branch from the main nerve, from the main vessels. Okay, next. We'll proceed by drawing the deeper layer, which is parietal pleura. Then deeper to the parietal pleura, we have a space here called the pleural cavity, where the pleural fluid accumulates. And then deeper to it, we have the visceral pleura. And then the last layer, we have lung tissues, represented by this dotted part here. Okay, just to recap, I'm going to be labeling the drawing. First one. Skin. I'll just do initials. This one. Superficial fascia. Deeper to it, we have serratus anterior. Okay, this part here, this three part, are the intercostal vein, intercostal artery, and intercostal nerve. Okay, next we have this muscle here, which is external intercostal. This one here, we have internal intercostal. This one here, we have for innermost, I'll use lowercase I, innermost intercostal. Next is this one here, we have parietal pleura. Empty part here, we have pleural cavity. Second last layer is visceral pleura. Then last part here, we have lungs. Okay. As for the clinical significance of this drawing, is that one of the clinical significance is the thoracocentesis. Okay. Thoracocentesis, where pleural fluid is actually aspirated from the pleural cavity here, but the way to aspirate it is by inserting a needle in between the two ribs. One point to take note of is that because the intercostal space here has these three intercostal vein, artery, and nerve, the needle which is inserted at the intercostal space is advised to be away from the ribs, in order to make sure that the needle doesn't actually hit the intercostal nerve. Okay, that's one. Next is one more thing is intercostal nerve block, in which a local anesthesia is actually administered in this part here to block the nerve transmission from intercostal nerve. I think that's it for this drawing. Typical intercostal space. Anything else? I think none. Oh, okay. One last thing is not so important, but again, just label it. This part here is the collateral branches. As for the other, you can just follow the colors, which is from the top to bottom, nerve, artery, vein. And I think that's it for this session. Thank you and jazakallah khair for watching the video.